is where a plant is going to take carbon dioxide and water, and it's going to make food for itself. And it's going to get the energy to put in those food bonds are going to come from the sun. Now, we have to have a place where we can capture the sun energy, and that's going to be captured in the organelle called the chloroplast. And the chloroplast is green because it has a green pigment called chlorophyll that's able to capture the sun but not be heated up by the sun and then release it into energy that the plant can capture chemically to make food. Now, as we do this lab, one of the things we're looking at is we want to prove, you guys have learned probably one time, you know that somehow a plant takes sun and makes food, but we want to prove it and have it see that that's actually occurring. And so what we've done is, we've got, if we can see carbon dioxide being used up, then we know that the plant has made food. We might not be able to see the plant getting bigger in the course of lab. We might not be able to see it actually getting fuller in the course of lab or growing, but we know it makes food if we can see carbon dioxide disappear. And when we made our little phenol red solutions, we blew into it and we put CO2 in it, and the more CO2 we added, it changed color. And as we added that CO2, that yellow change to the phenol red shows us that there's CO2 in there. When we add plants and put it in the sunlight, that plant will be taking that CO2, extracting it, combining the carbon dioxide into our food molecule, and as such, the CO2s will begin to get used up. And as the CO2s get to get used up, there'll be less and less, as we have less and less CO2s, we'll have less and less hydrogens because it stays in equilibrium. And that'll cause the pH to rise again, and we'll see the phenol red turn back to red. It'll go from a shade of yellow back to red, proving that it was the plant inside the container that was switching it from yellow to red as it uses up CO2.